वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू. माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर एस आर चाकणे, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ ॲग्रोनॉमी ॲट सद्गुरू कॉलेज ऑफ ॲग्रिकल्चर, मिरजगाव. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक दॅट इज इनिशिएटिव टेकन बाय द गव्हर्नमेंट, एन जी ओ अँड द ऑर्गनायझेशन्स फॉर द प्रमोशन ऑफ ऑर्गॅनिक ॲग्रिकल्चर इन इंडिया. In that, firstly, we will discuss about the various schemes which are promoting the organic farming in country, and that includes the various scheme as the first one, that is the National Project on Organic Farming, second one, that is the National Horticulture Mission, third one, the Horticulture Mission for Northeast and the Himalayan State, then fourth one, Rashtriya Krushi Vikas Yojana, and the last one, that is the Network Project on Organic Farming of Indian Council of Agricultural Research. So these are the various schemes which are working for the promotion of the organic farming in our country. For that various schemes, the funds allocated under the NPOF, then National Horticulture Mission, then Rashtriya Krushi Vikas Yojana, and the HMNEH during the year 2013-14 are 427 lakh, then rupees 1215.50 lakh, and rupees 14,015 lakh, and lastly the 1162.05 lakh respectively. These are the various funds which are allocated for the various scheme in our country for promotion of the organic farming. Then besides the ICAR under the Network Project on Organic Farming, with lead center at the Project Directorate for Farming System Research, Modipuram is developing the package of practices for of different crops and the cropping system under the organic farming in the various agroecological regions of the country. That means under the ICAR, the project work at the Project Directorate of the Farming System Research, which is located at Modipuram, which are developing the new package of practices for the various crops and the cropping system under the organic farming to the different agroecological regions of our country. Presently, the project is running at 13 cooperative centers, including the state agricultural universities. These are spread over the 12 states. Then, the ICAR Institute, that including the state agricultural organic fertilizers. Then, after that, the ICAR Institutes, that including the state agricultural universities, that impart the training and organize the frontline demonstration to educate the farmers on aspect that is related to the organic fertilizers. Then there are the various schemes. They are working to promote the organic farming in India. In that, the first important scheme, that is the National Program for Organic Production. This NPOP scheme, this was implemented in year 2001. And this scheme, which involves the following points as first one, that is the accreditation programs for the certification agencies. Then second one, that is the norms which are developed for the organic production. And last one, that is the promotion of the organic farming. That means these are the three important points which are involved in the National Program for Organic Production. Then after that, the following states that have been promoting the organic farming through this scheme, and these various scheme, these various states, which includes the Kerala, Uttaranchal, then Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Nagaland, then Gujarat, Rajasthan, Tamil Nadu, Sikkim, and Mizoram. These states which have been promoting the organic farming in our country. Then this program that provides the information on organic production standards, then what are the various criteria and what procedures we have to follow for the accreditation of inspection and the certification bodies. Then the standards as well as the procedures have been involved in line with the global standards like the Codex. Then the National Program for the Organic Production Standards for the production and the accreditation have been recognized by the European Commission and Switzerland as well as the United States Department of the Agriculture. Then this program is a cluster-based program for the promotion of the organic farming. In this program, the 50 or more farmers that will form a one cluster with a 50-acre land that used to carry out the organic farming under this scheme. In 3 years, around 10,000 clusters will form that covering a 5 lakh acre area under the organic farming. Then the farmer will have no liability for expenditure on the certification. During this program, each farmer will be given the Indian rupees of 20,000 per acre in 3 years for the seed to harvesting of crops and the transport of produce to the market. Then organic farming will also be promoted via the traditional resources as the part of the scheme. That means the various traditional resources as well as the methods which are also used as a part of the scheme. Then the linkages will be formed between the organic products and the markets as per the scheme. The scheme will also increase the domestic production and the certification of organic produce through the medium of farmers. Then amount of the Indian rupees 300 crore has been sanctioned for this scheme in year 2015-2016. Then this scheme works towards making the organic farming sustainable, then more remunerative, that means the more advantageous to the farmer, and it also making the climate resistant. Then efforts are also on to develop the natural resources and promote the efficient water use of more crop per drop for the organic farmers. The schemes also works to develop the capacity of organic farmers and the stakeholders in conjunction with the other missions. Then this scheme will also leverage the other schemes such as the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, then IWMP, that means the Integrated Watershed Management Program, and the RKVY, that means the Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana. It will also establish the departmental or the ministerial coordination for the deliverables under the scheme. Then it will work towards the development of know-how and the research and development for the organic farmers. Then the mission especially involves the soil health management, and that can be achieved through the residue management. That means the whatever the residue which is available that can be used for increasing the fertility status of the soil, and it can be also managed through the various organic farming practices. These organic practices which involves the creation and the linking of soil fertility maps with macro and the micronutrient management, then the relevant land use based on the land use capability, judicious application of the fertilizers, and the minimization of soil erosion and the soil degradation. Then the scheme will be implemented by the state government, then National Center of Organic Farming, Central Fertilizer Quality Control and Training Institute, as well as the Soil and Land Use Survey of India, FACTS, and the states. Then the area under the cultivation of certified organic farming that has grown the 17-fold in the past one decade from 42,000 hectare area in 2003-2004, and that will be increases up to 7.23 lakh hectare in year 2013-14. Then the government of India has also implemented the several other programs and the various scheme for boosting the organic farming in India, which includes the Rashtriya Krushi Vikas Yojana, then the Mission for the Integrated Development of Horticulture, then National Mission on Oilseed and the Oil Palm Network Project on Organic Farming of ICAR, then the area under the organic certification in 2013-2014, according to an Associam report, was 4.72 million hectare. In this way, in this lecture number 2 and 3, we have discussed about the various schemes and the various programs they are implementing for the boosting up of the organic farming in India. In this program, the various government as well as the non-government organizations which are also involved for boosting up of organic farming in India. Thank you.